Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Math Voyage 2024. Today we are going to do addition and subtraction word problems, numbers up to 100, and also try to understand the importance of the first three digit number 100. So please stay tuned until the end of the video. Let us try to understand the importance of 100. 100 is a big milestone number in math. It's the first three-digit number and shows a full count of 10 tens. Now let us take a number line, mark from 0 to 100 and take 10 steps of 10. 9, 10. So it is 10 tens is 100. 100 helps us understand place value. It's made up of 100 zero tens and zero ones. A one in ones place has value 1. But if we move the one in tens place, we have 110 or number 10. If we move the one more time to hundreds place, we have 100 or 100. We see 100 in many places like 100 paise in 1 rupee, 100 cents in a dollar, 100 years in a century. The number 100 is often celebrated like the 100th day of school. When a school, building or organization has been around for 100 years, we celebrate its 100th anniversary, called centenary. When someone turns 100 years old, it's a huge celebration called a centennial birthday. It means they have lived for a whole century. Here there are 10 word problems. I have solved 3 for you. You can try the remaining 7. I'll provide the solutions in my next video on patterns. Now here the first question is, James has 32 Christmas cards. His friend gives him 15 more. How many Christmas cards does James have now? You have to solve this using units and tens. So mark tens and ones first. Write 32 Christmas cards, 3 in tens place and 2 in ones place. And the 15 cards which his friend gives him, you can write it this way, 1 and 5. And then you have to add. Now for adding, you have to add ones place first and then tens place. You can add using fingers. Use fingers for small number and count on fingers numbers after big number. So 2 plus 5, 2 in hand, and count after 5. So it comes out to be 7. And same way, 3 plus 1, 1 in hand, and count after 3. So you get here 47. So the answer is James has 47 Christmas cards. The next question is, there are 25 ornaments on the Christmas tree. Mom adds 14 more ornaments. How many ornaments are on the tree now? Solve using units and tens. Same way you can do. The third question is, Maya wraps 41 gifts in the morning. She wraps 28 more gifts in the afternoon. How many gifts did she wrap in total? You can use whichever method you want. The next question is, there are 46 Christmas lights on the porch. Dad adds 21 more lights. How many Christmas lights are there now? Solve using a number line. So you have already learned how to use number line for adding. Let's take a number line here, marked from 30 to 90. Now step 1 is, start at 46 on the number line because 46 Christmas lights were there on the porch. Step 2, add 21. Method is, move 20 steps forward and then move one more step. From 46, you are moving 20 steps forward and then move one more step. So where will you reach? You will reach 67. Therefore, the answer is, there were 67 lights in all. Here is the fifth question. At the Christmas party, there were 55 guests. By the end of the party, 27 guests had left. How many guests are still at the party? Solve using a number line. So again, we'll take a number line first and here I have marked from 10 to 70. The step 1 is start at 55 because there are 55 guesses. 55 is 5 divisions after 50. Step 2 is you have to subtract 27. So for that you have to move 20 steps backward to reach 35. So here 45 and then 35. And by the end of the party, 27 guests are left. So you have to take how many more? 7 more steps backwards to reach 28. So the answer is 28 guests are still at the party. Here there are 5 more questions. You can try to do it yourself and check the answers later. You can use whichever method you want. That's all in this video. Merry Christmas! Happy Holidays! Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to know when I post my next video. Bye! Take care!